Hi everyone, I'm continuing with the Christmas theme today. This column was written in December 1980, so that's the first year I started writing. I'm almost a whole year in at this point. It's called A Gift Wrapper's Dilemma. My words may be a little crooked or cockeyed today. I have a slight handicap, which is making it almost impossible to type. No, I haven't broken anything yet, though my fingers couldn't be more useless if they were in splints. The problem is my digits are taped to a Christmas package. Everything started a while back when I decided it was time to put the final touches on the assortment of goodies hidden in my closet. In the past, I have questioned the benefits of using colored paper. I resolved to forego the added expense, the waste of time, and skip it. This would give our tree a lived-in look with bundles of shopping bags stuffed underneath in a typical holiday arrangement. So far, I fought off this grocery bag compulsion and used printed paper. But knowing what to do and accomplishing the same is quite different. I'd say my spirit is willing, but my fingers are, well, I cut a piece of red paper, which, though precisely measured, always comes up an inch or two short. This last section can never be patched with the odd pieces of scraps left over and ends up with a square or two of purple to bring it all together. Then I try to cover up this patched up package with ribbon and a bow. I can't understand why they don't make ribbons wide enough. Modern ribbons cover very little and do nothing for my lopsided bows. Another wrapping experience is working with Christmas paper off a roll. An octopus doesn't have enough arms to work with this stuff. The paper has to be attacked to be cut. It keeps trying to get away. The paper then has to be whirled into place around the package and held. A roll of tape and is placed between your teeth. It is scratched at for an hour to find the end, which healed back on the roll from last time. If the end is found, the tape has to be peeled and cut. Then a second before the tape contacts the paper, fingers cramp and let go. The paper recoils into its original tube form. The tape in hand sticks to it, and as everything is unwound, a big hunk of paper rips off. Finally, by some miracle, the package is wrapped. I stand back to admire my work after prying my fingers from the tape and ribbon. What do I see? A gift fit to grace our tree? No, I see bold print under the paper, clearly proclaiming the gift to be a heavy-duty monster machine. When the gifts are finally wrapped and placed beneath the tree, I turn on the lights to get the total effect. Yuck. I should have used the shopping bags. The lopsided ribbons and the patched paper stand out perfectly under those lights. My only salvation is I know the children will wake up soon and rip all my work into shreds and never notice the patches. I did a lot of wrapping at the end of Christmas Eve. Mostly Bob didn't help, but in later years he did. But those early years, it was up to me. And I shouldn't wait to the very last minute. Don't wait to the very last minute. It's not a good idea. So I wish you a good day and fond memories. Until next time.